Please be seated. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to be here with you, people of Church of the Epiphany. My name is Nicole Janelle, and I currently serve as Executive Director of the Abundant Table, an Episcopal Lutheran farm and faith community located up the road from here in Ventura County. This church has been a longtime supporter of the ministries of the Abundant Table, and so for that, I thank you. In the Christian church, the 23rd Psalm is perhaps most known and one of the most beloved pieces of the 150-long Book of Psalms. Quoted with almost cliched regularity at funerals, but also in times of distress or times of trial, its tangible pastoral imagery and powerful message cannot help but draw us in. This week, I found myself coming back to this line from the psalm. You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup is running over. Such a radical and astounding invitation. An invitation to sit at a table, presumably an abundant table, laden with fruits, vegetables, and grains of every variety. Honored as a guest, made visible through this traditional gesture of anointing with oil. Have you ever had such an experience? I hope that you're all nodding your inner heads right now, because this, my friends, is what the Eucharistic meal that we reenact Sunday after Sunday seeks to be. A gathering of people who honor one another around an abundant table and receive, in turn, the gift of the cup that runneth over. In other words, the experience of a soul that is full, a heart that sings. And throughout it all, God is there. In times of communal rejoicing, God is there. In times of despair, God is there. God is there protecting the people with God's rod and God's staff. God is there raising people to new life. God is there a witness to the people who have survived the great ordeal. God is there to say, you are my sheep. I call you by name. Over 10 years ago, a small, faithful campus ministry community made up of Episcopalian Lutherans and some others at Cal State Channel Islands in Camarillo had an experience very similar, I think, to what we read about in this line that I have lifted up from Psalm 23. Meeting faithfully Sunday after Sunday for Eucharist, they came to recognize their particular calling. To help restore the food system from ground to table. As one founding member has shared, never in a million years did we imagine that would be our calling. But we said yes, and it's been a joy and a pain ever since. It's satisfying work, challenging work, work that needs more than we can give, but also opens up for us our need for God. At the Abundant Table, we look at different areas of our food system, that is, everything involved in bringing food from the ground to the table. It includes the soil where our food is grown, the methods used to grow it, the people who grow and harvest it, the way it's distributed, who has access to the food, and what kind of food they have access to, even how the food is received and enjoyed or not by human beings. We look at all these different aspects of the food system and ask questions like, is it good for the earth? Is it good for people, all the people involved? Does this contribute, in the words of Jesus, to abundant life for all? And how could it be better? Today, the Abundant Table is proud to be farming 5 acres of leased land at McGrath Family Farm off of the Central Avenue exit of the 101 in Camarillo. Our three-member farm team grows a variety of mostly vegetables, but also some fruits, using organic, sustainable practices. This bounty is shared with public school cafeterias and members of the community-supported agriculture program who receive a box of fresh fruits and vegetables on a weekly or bi-weekly basis. We do deliver boxes to this area, and so if you'd like to learn more, speak to me after the service. In addition to our working farm, our director of farm education, a Ventura County native who came to the Abundant Table through the campus ministry and graduated from our young adult intern program, goes into the public schools to teach nutrition education and agricultural literacy, which means that she accompanies students, many of whom come from under-resourced backgrounds, as they learn to appreciate the unique flavors of God's creation and understand principles of sustainability. Her students, as well as others who come to the farm for field trips, love to get their hands dirty, pulling carrots and beets out of the ground. A commitment to gathering around a common table continues to undergird the spiritual life of the Abundant Table. Farm Church, as it is now affectionately known, meets every Sunday evening, hosted by church members, many of whom are young adults, in homes, apartments, and backyards. We gather to read the scriptures, to reflect on them in community, to break bread, and to feast around a table of potluck-laden abundance that always contains quite a few vegetables and fruits grown and harvested on the farm. The story and the continued witness of the Abundant Table is for me a powerful one. Having only recently stepped in as executive director, it's not one for which I can take any credit. Like some of you here who may through the years have participated or supported some aspect of the Abundant Table's ministry, I have tremendous respect for how the initial members, interns, and staff of the Abundant Table dedicate themselves for the benefit of all of us, really, to this sacred work of rerooting the Christian tradition in the land and creating a space for all sorts of people to experience a sense of connectedness to the land and the food it produces, as well as a sense of wonder at God's magical creation. Needless to say, the Abundant Table does all of this on a shoestring. Through CSA and produce sales, grants and community donations, we are able to pay our staff of seven fair wages, but not wages they truly merit given the experience and the credentials they bring to the table. One of our greatest challenges is that as a cash-poor, largely woman-run organization, we do not have access to the amount of capital it would take to buy our own land. As a result, our farm has moved three times in the last 10 years and currently is halfway through a two-year lease. We long for the day we can call a piece of land home and develop a theology of place like that which has anchored so many other farm-based spiritual communities. But for now, we can only talk about a theology of displacement and the significant challenges associated with learning to farm a new piece of land every few years. We like to say at the Abundant Table that just as it takes a diversified ecosystem to sustain a farm, the same is true with our ministry. No matter what setting, when we gather in diversified community around a common table, we bring a variety of strengths, weaknesses, experiences, gifts that allow for a communal and individual experience of abundance. We are made for connection with each other, with God, with the earth, and so often that vehicle for connection, that communion really, is food set upon a shared table. Jesus knew that. That's why so much of his ministry happened at tables and why he chose a shared meal of simple food, bread and wine, to be the way he would continue to be present to his disciples and to us after his death. "This is my body," he said. "This is my blood. When you share it around a table, remember me." As we are in the great 50 days of Easter, I invite you this week to reflect upon the image of gathering around a table and the joy God invites us to experience through this increasingly countercultural act. What parts of yourself this Easter season need to be reinvigorated or resurrected even through the help of a community that gathers around a table to feed each other? Food shared at table is communion, the place where we meet God, each other, and the earth with gratitude and joy, having offered and received peace and reconciliation from God through Christ and from each other. We will experience that this morning, and that experience is meant to inform all of our meals during the week. God invites you, so come to the table. Come sit as the honored guest and receive your anointing. Be nourished, be filled, and experience the joy of the cup that runneth over.